Hello children, hope all of you are doing great. In this video lesson, we are going to solve few questions that were asked during the previous years in the International Maths Olympiad Level 2 examination for Standard 4. And solving these questions will definitely be helpful for you for your preparation. Before I start solving, I would like to give you a tip. In Olympiad examinations, the way to succeed or the way to score good marks depends on how you approach the question. So always keep this in mind. The way you solve the question is very important, and also keep in mind that the options are given to you to help you arrive at the answer for the question. So as we solve each question, I will try and teach you the best way in which you can approach this question in the examination. The first question is there on your screen. Mohan reaches the school by a school bus in 3/8 hours. So usually Mohan reaches school by using school bus in 3/8 hours. If he walks to school, it takes him 3/4 hours. How much more time does it take him to walk to school than to go by bus? So if Mohan is going to the school by bus, what is the time taken? It takes him 3/8 hours. If Mohan is going to the school by walking, right, how much time does he take? Or how much time does it take him? It takes him 3/4 hours. So how much more time does it take for him to walk than to go by bus? See, if I say Mohan takes 3 hours to go to school by walk and Mohan takes 2 hours to go to school by bus, then how much more time does he take to walk to school than to go by bus? Nothing but 3 minus 2, that is 1 hour. 1 hour extra, right, he takes if he is walking. Similarly, here, if he is going by bus, he is taking 3/8 hours. If he is going walking, he is taking 3/4 hours. So how much more time does he take when he walks than when he goes by bus? 3/4 minus 3/8. What will be the answer? So here, if you see, the denominators are different, correct? So you cannot subtract these fractions directly. So what should you do? You have to make the denominator common. So what will we do? This first fraction that is there here, right, 3/4, we will multiply this numerator and denominator by 2, so that the denominator of both the fractions becomes the same. So this will become 6/8 minus 3/8. Now you can subtract these two fractions, right? So this will become 6 minus 3/8, which is equal to 3/8 hours. So the correct answer here is option B, 3/8 hours. I hope it is clear. Let's look at the next question. Find the value of the sum of these two Roman numbers. The first Roman numeral that we have is this. And what is the, which number does this represent? See, L represents 50 and XX, that it means that after 50, 20 after 50. So 50 plus 20 plus, this is 6. So 50 plus 20 plus 6, which is 76. Next, what does this Roman numeral represent? So XC means 10 before 100, that is 90, and this is 7. So 90 plus 7, that is 97. Now what is the sum of 76 and 97? Sum of 76 and 97 is 173. What is the Roman numeral representation of 173? Just look at the options given here. So this is 100, 50, 20 and 3, correct? So C is 100, then you have L is 50, then you have 20 after 50 and 3, which is nothing but 173. This is 173. Option A represents 173. Option B represents what? This is 50, 50 plus 20, 70 plus 2, 72. No, that is not the answer option that we are looking for. Obviously, A has to be your answer. But anyway, let's check option C as well. What does option C stand for? C is 100, 50, 22. So, that is 100 plus 50 plus 20 plus 2, which is equal to 172. Wrong answer option. Similarly, option D is also wrong. Obviously, option A is going to be your answer. In the examination, once you know the answer is 173, and once you find out that option A is the Roman numeral representation of 173, mark that as your answer and move on to the next question. A jeweler made 4 gold ornaments weighing 14 grams 200 milligrams, 15 grams 900 milligrams, 9 grams 700 milligrams and 5 grams 900 milligrams. What is the total weight of the four ornaments? So you just have to add all of these weights together. So 45 grams and 700 milligrams. That will be your answer, correct answer. That is option. When you are solving this question in the examination, you should not be actually solving the complete question. When you start adding these weights, right? When you come to the milligram part, see, we will add from this end, right? When you add from this end, you have 700. In terms of milligrams, what do you have? You have 700. There is only one option which has 700 milligram. Obviously, that has to be your answer. So, don't even waste your time adding up this part. It's not required. In the examination, don't waste your time adding up this grams part just by looking at the, just by adding the milligrams part, right? You know, milligrams answer is going to be 700. When you look at the options, there is only one option which has 700 milligrams. Mark that as your answer and move on to the next question. Solve the question faster and move on to the next question. You can save time using this method, okay? So add up the weights, and when you get the answer for the milligram part, check with the options. There is only one option which has 700 milligram. That has to be your answer. Mark that as your answer and move on to the next question. Let us now look at the next question. Elections were held in a city in May 2000. The four candidates in election got 12,906, 13,545, 23,342 and 102 votes individually. Find the total number of votes polled. So you have to add up all of these. You have to add up all the votes that is received by the candidates. So what will you get when you add up all these numbers? 6 plus 5 is 11, plus 2 is 13, 13 plus 2 is 15. So 15, 5, 1 carryover. See, at this point itself, we can eliminate option B. Option B is wrong because it is ending with 8. So the correct answer either has to be A, C or D. And then 4 plus 4 is 8, 8 plus 1 is 9. So, which is the option which ends with 9-5? There is only one option which ends with 9-5. Option D. Mark that as your answer and move on to the next question. Don't waste your time for trying to find out what will be the remaining answer that will come here. It is not required. When you know that the last two digits of the answer is 9-5, there is only one option which has the last two digits as 9-5. Mark that as your answer and go to the next question. So, the correct answer here is 49,895. Next. A petrol pump had 98,000 liters of petrol. 5,655 liters of petrol was sold on the first day, 15,666 liters on the second day and 38,565 on the third day. How much petrol was left after the third day? So, what should you do here? See, totally how much petrol was there? 98,000 liters of petrol was there. And how much petrol was sold on the first day? 5,655 liters of petrol was sold on the first day and 15,666 liters on the second day and 38,565 on the third day. So, totally how much petrol was sold? We have to add up these three. The answer that you get, whatever be the answer, that answer you have to subtract from 98,000. 98,000 minus the answer that you get here. So, that is the answer that we are looking for. How will you find this out? See, you have 5 plus 6 plus 5, that is 16. 6 and 1 carryover. Again here, there is a shortcut to solve the question. Ideally, what will you do? You will add up all of these numbers, find out the answer and subtract this from 98,000. But here, one clue that I have is the last digit of the answer that I get here is going to be 6. So, when I subtract 98,000 minus the answer that I get here, whatever be that answer, okay, whatever be the answer that I get here, the last digit is going to be 6. And when I try to subtract 0 minus 6, what will happen? I will have 10 minus 6 is 4. So, what can I say? I can say that the last digit of my answer is going to be 4. And there is only one option which has 4 in the last digit, which is option B. So, option B has to be my correct answer. Is it clear? Even though this question is very calculative, do not waste your time trying to solve the complete question. At this point itself, you know that the correct answer is going to be option B. Okay, how did we find that out? See, first we had to find out totally how much petrol was sold. When I tried to find out the sum, I got that the last digit of that answer is 6. So whatever be the answer that I get, I have to subtract that answer from 98,000. So 0 minus 6 is 4. So anyway, for the final answer, the last digit is going to be 4. And so from the options, there is only one option which has the last digit as 4. So the correct answer has to be option B. Meena makes 45 bags in a day in her factory. How many paper bags can she make in a leap year? In a leap year, how many days are there? There are 366 days. In one day, how many bags does Meena make? Meena makes 45 bags. So how many bags will she make in the leap year? 366 multiplied by 45. So what will be your answer? Multiply and check. 6 5s are 30, 0 3 carry over. Again you have 6 5s are 30, 3 carry over. 5 3s are 15, 18. 6 4s are 24, 4. At this point stop. Don't solve further, right? 6 4s are 24, 2 carry over. Whatever be the remaining value that comes. You know the last digit of the answer is going to be 0. And the second last digit is going to be 4 plus 3. 7. There is only one option which ends with 70. Obviously, that has to be your answer. That is option C. Mark that as your answer and move on to the next question. I hope it is clear. See, remember, in Olympiad examinations, you do not have to completely solve and find out the exact answer. Many times, by looking at the options, you will be able to arrive at the answer faster and you can move on to the next question. Always keep this in mind. The correct answer here is option C. When you solve such questions faster, the time that you save, you can use it for achiever section question or difficult questions. Okay? Let us now move on to the next question. A fruit seller bought 1,000 apples. He threw away 28 apples that were rotten. He packed the remaining apples equally in 36 boxes. How many apples were there in each box? So totally how many apples did the fruit seller have? He had 1,000 apples, and from that 1,000 apples, 28 apples were rotten. So how many apples were remaining? How many apples did he have remaining with him? He had 972 apples remaining with him. And what did he do? He packed this 972 apples in 36 boxes equally. So how many apples will be there in each box? 972 divided by 36. So when you divide, what will you get the answer as? You will get the answer as 27. Or I can say each box will have 27 apples. Correct answer is option D, 27. The maximum number of factors of a number 8 is dash. What are the factors of 8? The factors of 8 are 1, 2, 4 and 8. So what are the maximum number of factors of 8? There are 4 factors. For number 8. Your correct answer is option C, 4. Next one. Arrange the given fractions in ascending order. Ascending order means from smallest to the biggest. This is a very easy question and a mark scoring 1, 2. What will be your correct answer? Correct answer is option D, 10 by 11, 17 by 11, 21 by 11 and 59 by 11. We are arranging the fraction in the increasing order of their value. Correct answer is option D. Very easy question, right? A mark scoring one. So I hope all the questions that we solved in this video lesson was clear to all of you, and I hope all of you understand the way in which you have to approach the questions in the examination. Like I said in the beginning of the session, your approach is very, very important. The strategy that you follow in the examination is very critical to get you a good score in the second level examination. We will solve more such questions in the upcoming sessions. So all the very best with your preparations, and I will see you in another video lesson. And if you like our videos, do subscribe to our channel for more such videos. Thank you.